Students, today we are going to study about the properties by which materials are classified. The classification makes the materials group into different categories according to their properties. In this video, we are going to study about which are the properties by which the materials are put into different groups. The first property, that is luster. Here in this picture you can see gold ornaments, silver ornaments and platinum ornaments. You can see the diamonds, you can see the gemstones, different colors. What do all these pictures show? All these materials, gold, silver, platinum, diamonds, gemstones, all these are shiny in appearance. The shining nature of the materials, that is called luster. We can classify the materials into lustrous or non-lustrous according to their shining property. Here in this picture, the pebbles or the marbles in showing in this picture, that is shiny in appearance. So we can say that these are lustrous. And children, the shining materials, when they lost their luster, we can say that they are tarnished. That means they lost their shining property and they become dull in appearance. Here you can see the iron objects also, they are also tarnished. That is called rust appeared on its surface by polishing or cleaning with the sandpaper or cleaning the metals with cloth, we can get back the luster of the materials. Okay, then the next property by which materials are classified, that is roughness of the surfaces. Roughness or smoothness of the surfaces. Here in this picture you can see the wall made of brick and the wall made of stone. In both these cases, the surface is rough. We can say that the ups and downs are there on the surface of these materials that make these surfaces rough. Then children, you can see the mirror here. The mirrors made up of polished glass, different shaped mirrors are this. When we touch the mirrors, we can understand that the surface of the mirror is smooth. A glass tumbler, plates made of stainless steel, they are smooth to touch. So children, we can understand that according to the next property, the materials are divided into rough materials and smooth materials. Now we are going to study about transparency. In transparency, the materials are divided into transparent, translucent and opaque materials. Here the glass made used in this aquarium and also the water filled in this aquarial tank, both are transparent. That's why the inner objects we can see clearly, the plants, the fish and the pebbles we can see, because the glass is transparent as well as the water is transparent. Some transparent organisms are there, some type of fish, their internal organs we can see, the bones we can see, because they are transparent, because the light passes through these objects completely. So the transparent materials are the materials from which the light can pass easily. Here the wings of the dragonfly is transparent. We can see the veins of the leaf clearly because it is transparent. In transparency, the next type of material, that is translucent material, it allows only partial passage of light. We can see a faint image of the object, the x-ray sheets, the ground glass and the butter paper. We can see a faint image of the fingers. Then here the glass that is used, that is translucent, through which we can see the faint image of the leaves. Here in this room The walls are made up of translucent glass. Inside the objects are there, some boxes are there, but we cannot understand its exact color because we get only a faint image. Here in this, the paper that is translucent because we cannot see the clear image of the hand because it is translucent. Then the next property by which materials are classified, softness or hardness of materials. The soft materials, they are soft to touch. You can see the silk cloth, sponge, the talcum powder, they are soft materials. While the powder tin, the baby powder, it's a tin, that is hard material. It cannot be pressed easily. The hard materials cannot be pressed easily, but the soft materials can be pressed easily. The cotton candy is soft, but the batis are hard. Then children, the property by which the materials sink or float. The materials are divided into sinking materials or floating materials. The heavy objects, the denser objects, they sink in liquids or solvents, they will sink. But the materials, they are light in weight, they will float on the surface of a liquid. That is called the sinking and floating capacity of materials. Materials can be divided into sinking or floating materials. Another property by which materials are classified is the solubility. That is, the salt is dissolved in water. The material which dissolves, that is called the solute, and the liquid in which the solute dissolves, that is called solvent. When the solute and the solvent is mixed, we call it a solution. Now in this, the salt dissolves in water and we will get the salt solution. Like that, the soap powder, that is dissolved in water, sugar dissolved in water. So there are many materials, they are dissolved in water, and that property is called solubility. We must remember that the water is a universal solvent. Many materials can be dissolved in water, but there are some other substances in which the materials can dissolve, just like ether, vinegar, organic solvents, etc. Here, solubility, the solute is the material added to a solvent, that is the liquid. When the solute and the solvent mix together, we will get a solution, and that property to dissolve materials, that is called solubility. Then students, the next property we are going to study, that is malleability and ductility. In malleability, the metal is hammered into thin sheets. When we hammer a metal, whether it is gold, whether it is silver or copper or aluminium, whatever it may be, when the metals are hammered, they changed into very thin sheets. That property is called malleability. Gold is the most malleable metal. Then children, the property by which the metals can be drawn into very thin wires, that is called ductility. Here the copper wire, you can see in this picture. Gold is ductile, aluminium, copper, iron. There are many metals, they are ductile in nature. We can change them into wires. Then children, miscibility and immiscibility of materials. In this property, the liquids readily mix together, they dissolve and make a solution. For example, the lemon juice that is poured into water, when we stir it, it becomes a solution. That means it becomes the lime juice. If we add a pinch of salt and a spoon of sugar, it becomes lemonade or lime juice. So children, that is miscible in water. We can say that the shampoo and the liquids like Ujala, Dettol, all these are also miscible in water. They mixes with the liquid very well. Then children, here you can see beer, some hot drinks also mix in solutions or mix in various liquids, especially in water. Some liquids will not mix with other liquids. They are called immiscible. Here you can see in the picture, that is the water and kerosene. You can say that they are immiscible. That means they form different layers. They change into separate layers. We can say that immiscible. Here oil and water also immiscible. They form separate layers. So children, we have seen these are the properties of materials by which the substances are classified.